again to another Java short tutorial. And in this video and a few upcoming videos, I'm going to talk about building GUIs in Java using the Swing library. So let's get started. I've already created a project. So let's create a class called Swing Example 1. And like every other class, even if we're going to build a GUI class, we need a main method, or at least in the first class that contains our main GUI. So there we go. Okay, so if we are going to use this class to have a one-screen GUI, we need to extend this class from JFrame. And what is a JFrame? Well, a JFrame is essentially a Windows window, like the window of my Eclipse. So in order to run this Windows window JFrame, what I need to do in my main method is create a instance of the class I've created. So there you go. Sorry, not sing example, swing example. So there you go. So now I'm going, so far I've created a class which extends from JFrame. I've created an instance of this class in the main method. But now I'm going to create the actual GUI. So, and that I'm going to do in the constructor of this class. So swing example one. Okay, for a application to basically work, there's a few things we need to do. And first of all, we need to set the size of the window. So for that which is a method on the JFrame. So we're gonna say this.setSize. And the first parameter should be the width, so 300. And the second parameter should be the height, so 120. And both sizes are in pixels. Then I would like this window to have a title. So it's going to be swing example 1. The other thing I need to set is the default close operation. So what is the default close operation? Well, every window has a cross icon at the top right corner. And it's the default close operation basically indicates what happens when you press that cross. So in this case, I want the program to terminate when the cross is clicked. So I say JFrame exit on close. Okay, lastly, to make our GUI appear, we need to set the JFrame to visible. So we're going to say this.setVisible. True. There you go. Alright, now let's run this and see what happens. So there we have our swing application of 300 pixels wide and 120 pixels high, if I'm correct. Okay. So, but just a empty window is kind of boring. So we should add some controls to it. You can set your controls in Swing using multiple layout managers. The default one is the flow layout, which I will be demonstrating in this video. However, you can set your layout to using this.setLayout and then adding an instance there of whatever layout manager you want to use. The default is flow layout, but just for the sake of demonstration, I'm going to attach that very same flow layout over there. Okay, this will actually make no difference on whether or not I added this or not added this, but like I said, this for I want to demonstrate how you can attach a layout. Okay, so now let's create some controls. So say if I want to add a label, which I'm going to declare a label, a text field, and a button. Well, in this case I will declare my controls globally. So that will be JLabel, JLBL, name. And naturally this needs to be imported, but I will do that in a moment. I want a text field, JTF name. And I would like to have a button, JBTN add, for example. Okay, I need to import all these three controls, so I can do that in one go using right-click, source, organize imports. There we go, and now they are imported on the top. Okay, so now going back here. I'm going to initialize these controls. So I'm going to say okay, JLabel name equals new JLabel. And in between the brackets, I'm going to define the text of this label. So in this case, that will be name. I'm going to initialize the name text field, which is a new J text field. And lastly, I'm going to initialize the button as a new J button, which will have the text add. So there we go. Okay, I've now created these controls, but I've still not added them to my JFrame layout. So let's do that now. So how do we add a control to the layout? Well, we simply use the add operation of the JFrame. So add JLBL name, add JTF name, and add J button add. Okay, not add with two D's, not three D's. There we go. So now the controls are added and the J frame is already visible. So now let's see what happens if I run this. Not what I had intended. Probably because I need to indicate the size of the text field, so 20 characters in this case. So there we go. Yep, there you are. Okay, so don't forget the size of the text field when using a flow layout. Okay, so what do we have here? We have the name control, which we added first, the name label. Then we have the name text field we added second, and the add button, which we added third. So, and this also straight away illustrates what the flow layout actually does. What the flow layout does is based on the sequence the controls are added. It will add the first control in the top left corner, then the second control next to it, and the third control next to there. Unless it runs out of space, then it will basically push the control to the second row. And in this case, the default value also means that the controls will be center aligned. So the lonely add button at the second row ends up in the center. If I want to have this add button behind my text field, it is simply a matter of making the GUI a little bit bigger. So there you go. Now it's part of the first row. And since there was space to spare, all the controls are center aligned. Okay, say if I want to have them left aligned, what I can do is I can go to my flow layout and say flow layout left. So I'm adding the flow layout left parameter to the constructor of the actual flow layout. And as a result of this, all the controls become left aligned. Say if I were to make this smaller again, you'll see that the add button that is on the second row now becomes left aligned as well. So that is what this actually does. Naturally, if I want it the other way around, I can say flow layout right. And there you go, now the add button is on the right hand side. Okay, I may have remembered this, may have mentioned this default close operation, which basically terminates the program when you press the cross button. You can see that right now the program is running because I have the ability to stop the program using the stop button. If I close this, the stop button disappeared because there's no program running anymore. So say if I were to forget about this default close operation and then run the program will still run as per normal. If I press the cross button, the window will no longer be visible, but the application will still run in the background, which you can see here because my stop button is still visible. As a result, I need to stop it manually. Okay, so there you go. Let's just get that line back. One other thing I want to show for this video, and then I will continue in another video on something else, is the default decorated look and feel. So, just now my application followed a pretty standard Windows layout. Say if I don't like that, what I can do in my main method is say JFrame dot set default look and feel decorated true. And as a result of this, my layout takes a slightly more Java look and feel, which is what is called a decorated look and feel. So which one you want to use, pretty much up to personal preference. Okay, in my next videos I will explain more about other types of layout managers. But for now, see you next time.